فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
4. يعرف بدلالة الإجماع. The fourth way to know is by way of consent. Consent. Which is the hadith of the messenger, قتل الشارب الخمر في الرابعة. Killing the one who drinks khamr on the fourth attempt. Alcohol. He drinks the first time, he gets whipped. Second time, he gets whipped. Third time, he gets whipped. Fourth time, he's killed. This hadith, by way of consent, is known that it's abrogated. Because Abu Dawud and Tirmidhi narrate, Abu Dawud, sorry, narrated it. قال النووي, and Imam al-Nawawi said in Sahih Muslim, دل الإجماع, the consent has shown على نسخي that this hadith is abrogated. Now, some of you might say, can the ijma abrogate? We say no, but it shows abrogation. It shows there's an abrogation here. Okay? But it doesn't abrogate. والإجماع لا ينسخ ولا ينسخ. Okay? Abrogation, ijma cannot be abrogated and cannot abrogate. Ijma cannot be abrogated. You can't say there was ijma and the ijma got abrogated. That means opposition of ijma. And also the ijma cannot abrogate a text. But it can show abrogation. It can show that the narration is abrogated. What's the wisdom in abrogating? What's the wisdom? Is Allah changing his mind? He just wants to change his mind. By the way, I want you to all know, abrogation, does it happen in news? Yes or no?
Yes.
Then that's called a lie. You can't abrogate a story that you told. It's lying. You can't say this story happened. Oh, I abrogated it. That's you lying, correct? Abrogation happens in rulings. Are you with me?
No.
Nasq happens in ahkam, not in akhbar. A khabar either happened or didn't happen. How can you abrogate something? It either happened or not. You saying it didn't happen and you said it happened in the beginning is either one of the time. You were lying. Either this one or this one. Correct? So pay attention to that. What's the wisdom in and nasq abrogation? What's the wisdom? What's the hikmah in it? The hikmah is two most apparent benefits are in it. The first one is رعاية الأصلح للمكلفين تفضلا من الله تعالى لا وجوبا عليه. Is Allah تبارك وتعالى looking سبحانه وتعالى after the best for his creation, bestowing his mercy on them, and it's not obligatory on him. He chooses to do it. So Allah is having mercy on you. Show kindness and generosity. So what do you find out from there? That Allah loves you. But if Allah just gave you one rule and then you stuck by it, you don't really know how merciful and how kind Allah is. But when you realize Allah made this on me, and then after that He was kind enough to take it off me, Allah has done me a favor. So that is the benefit that He has. The second one is Allah testing His creation to see how strong they are. It's a test. So, امتحان المكلفين بامتثال الأوامر واجتناب النواهي. Allah is testing His creation. Huh? He's testing His creation by saying to them, this is what you have to do. When they try it, and they put themselves to the test, and Allah says, okay, now you guys, you've passed the test. I'll take it off you. I will take it off you. What's the difference between نسخ and تخصيص? What's the difference between the two? Nasakh and takhsis. To say this hadith is nasakh and this is khas. The difference between the two is, nasakh is basically lifting up the ruling in totality. Raf'u al-hukm bil-kulliyya. Nasakh means that you're uplifting the ruling in totality. It's gone. No more. It doesn't exist anymore. Such as the person who drank alcohol four times. The ruling is gone. Doesn't exist anymore. Takhsis is specifying it. It's قصر الحكم. You're specifying the ruling on على بعض أفراده in some of its types. So you're not taking all of it from it. You're specifying it on a particular. It's called رفع جزئي. Okay, the uplifting is two types, as you should all know. رفع كلي and رفع جزئي. General lifting and specific lifting. Are you guys with me? If it's generally all lifted, then this is called نسخ, abrogation. But if it's specifically lifted, then this is called takhsis. A lot of scholars have wrote books in Nasikh wal Mansuq. from the books is Ibn Shahin's book. Hazimi rahimahullah, he wrote a book in it, it's called Al-Ihtibar fi al-Nasikh wal-Mansukh min al-Athar. Burhanuddin al-Ja'buri, he wrote a book called Rusukh al-Ahbar. Also, the topic that we took before, which was the Muhkam and especially the Mukhtalif al-Hadith, especially Mukhtalif al-Hadith. A lot of scholars have written in that field as well. Shafi'i wrote a book called Ikhtilaf al-Hadith. Scholars disputed one another between the book of Imam al-Shafi'i, Ikhtilaf al-Hadith. Is it actually a particular book that Shafi'i wrote in and within itself? Or is it a chapter in his Kitab al-Umm? There's khilaf. Also, one of the scholars who wrote it is Ibn Qutaybah. He wrote a book called Ta'wil al-Mukhtalif al-Hadith. A lot of stuffs are in there. Also, Abu Ja'far al-Tahawi, Imam al-Tahawi, rahimahullah, in his kitab, Mushkil al-Athar. And it's, you can say it's one of the greatest books, the biggest books that have been written. Sakhawi, rahimahullah, said, إِنَّهُ قَابِلُ لِلْإِخْتِصَارِ. Sakhawi said, it's a book that should be abridged. And it also needs, what? Tartib and tahdeeb. It should be organized and to be, because it's all over the place. Now, the Shaykh then says after that, وَإِلَّا فَالتَّرْجِيحُ ثُمَّ التَّوَقُّفُ. So we spoke about if the narrations, he told us, rahimahullah, in سَلِمَ مِنَ الْمُعَارَضَةِ, if there's, it's safe from any opposition, then the hadith is called muhkam. If the hadith, there's a mu'arada, there's an opposition, which we spoke about last lesson, if we're able to bring it together, فَإِنْ أَمْكَنَ الْجَمْعُ, if we can bring it together, فَوَ مُخْتَلَفُ الْحَدِيثِ, this is called a مُخْتَلَفُ الْحَدِيثِ. If we can't bring it together, then we resort to what? We resort to which one came first. And finding out and verifying which one came first. Then we go to what is known as the first one is called نَاسِخ, and the next, the late kama is called الْمَنْسُخ. We now are going to go to, we are unable. Sheikh is now going into what? We can't even tell the time. We can't tell which one's first or not. The Sheikh says, وَإِلَّا فَالتَّرْجِيحِ. If you can't do that, resort to tarjih. Tarjih is to say what? It's to say that this is stronger, this is rajih, for this reason, this is reason. Sheikh is trying to say, أَنَّهُ إِن لَمْ يُمْكِنْ الْجَمْعَ. If you're unable to bring them together, between the two nusus which are muta'arada, and you're unable to know the tariq, then here it is possible you could do tarjih. You can do tarjih. Suyuti rahimahullah in his kitab Tadrib al-Rawi, he mentioned seven types of tarjih. Tarjih is to say that this is stronger than this one. He said the first one is tarjih bihal al-Rawi. You say that this is stronger because of the situation of the narrator. This is one of the ways to distinguish which one is rajih and which is marjuh. You say that this one is stronger because the narrator in his hadith, his situation, such as, for example, his memory is stronger, his fiqh, he's got more fiqh than the other one, or he was, you know, mulazamatu shuyukhi wa salamatu min at-tadlis. He is consistently known to be with the shaykh. He's far from tadlis and doing tadlis. That's one. The second one is الترجيح بالطرق المحتمل. It's to say that this is stronger than this one because صيغة الأداء, the way the hadith is submitted to us, the form that is used. Like for example, if it's سماع, if it's عرض, if it's إجازة, which we're going to come to inshallah, which are forms in which the hadith were taken. Okay? This is one of the ways to distinguish between which is stronger and which one is not stronger. The third one is الترجيح بكيفية الرواية, which is the hadith, to strengthen it due to how it was narrated. How? The fourth one is, like for example, if the hadith narrated by its wordings, or if the hadith is narrated by in terms of its meaning. We're going to come to it inshallah. Four, الترجيح بوقت الورود. Giving tarjih to the hadith because of when it came, when the hadith, it took place. 5. الترجيح بلفظ الخبر. To say that this is stronger because it's a خبر. It's an information. So for, what do we mean by in terms of it's being a خبر? For example, if it's general, we say it's خاص, عام, مطلق, مقيد, مفهوم, منطوق. You know, مفهوم الموافقة, مفهوم المخالفة. We go to the أصول الفقه field of it in order to explain it. So it's this is due to its خبر. Six is what? الترجيح بالحكم. Given ترجيح because of its rulings. Because of its ruling. Sixth is what? ترجيح because of أمر خارجي. To give ترجيح, to strengthen it because of external matter. We'll say, that this goes with an ayah of the Quran. So the ayah is going to support it. So we give that one strength. If those forms that we mentioned, and there may be more than that, then the scholars, what do they do? Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he then says, وَإِلَّا if ترجيح cannot be done, ثُمَّ تَوَقُّفُ. The scholars withhold. After they tried all of that, they still cannot bring the hadith which was stronger and which was what. So what did they result to now? ثُمَّ تَوَقُّفُ. You withhold, and you leave it for who? For a latecomer who can later maybe be able to bring the narrations together. You may not be able to, but he will. He will be able to. Naam. That now, in the book, brothers, is all maqbool. Maqbool is finished now. The hadith is finished, maqbool. Now we're going to go into mardood, the second type. Are you guys with me? All of that to this point was maqbool. The narration which are accepted. ثُمَّ الْمَرْدُودُ إِمَّا أَن يَكُونَ لِسَقْطٍ أَوْ طَعْنٍ فَالسَّقْطُ إِمَّا أَن يَكُونَ مِنْ مَبْدَأِ السَّرَدِ مِنْ مُصَنَّفٍ أَوْ مِنْ آخِرِهِ بَعْدَ التَّابِعِي أَوْ غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ فَالْأَوَّلُ الْمُعَلَّقُ. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he's now going into the khabar which is mardood, the rejected khabar. We've just finished the khabar which is maqbool. We finished it. Whilst we were studying the khabar which is maqbool, we took al-ma'mul wal-ma'mulu bihi. Al-ma'mul, the hadith which is implemented and that is done. The hadith which is taken and accepted. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he mentioned it. And now we're going to go into the khabar which is mardood, rejected, that we're not going to take. The rejected. Remember this, brothers. If a hadith is rejected, if a hadith is mardood, it's only mardood. So if a hadith is mardood, what does it mean? It means it's da'if. What does it mean?
Da'if.
It means that this hadith is da'if. And it's for two reasons why a hadith is rejected. Two reasons are the main two reasons. Either سقط, the disconnection that occurs in the chain of narration. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
Or الطعن في الراوي, or the criticism on the narrator, or a criticism on the narrator. The types of disconnection are two types. Are you guys with me?
No.
The type of disconnection is two types. What are they? سَقْطٌ ظَاهِرٌ, an apparent disconnection. And that's four of them. Four. There are only four of that. سَقْطٌ ظَاهِرٌ, a apparent disconnection. Are you guys with me? It's four types. It's the مُعَلَّق, it's the مُرْسَل, it's the مُعْضَل, and it's the مُنْقَطَع. Those four. The mu'allaq, the mursal, the mu'dal, and the munqata'. Those four. Those four are called saqtun zahirun. They're called saqt, disconnection which is apparent. If you look at those four, brothers, are you guys with me?
Mm-hmm.
Those four that I just mentioned right now, they are called what? Apparent disconnection, right? They are called what? Saqtun zahirun, apparent disconnection. Pay attention, brothers. What's the difference between all those fours? The difference between all those fours is بحسب المكان السخط, where the disconnection came from. That's the first difference between the four. And also عدد الرواة الذين سقطوا أسقطوا, sorry, عدد الرواة الذين أسقطوا. And also the number of narrators that were disconnected. That's the difference between these four. Okay? The difference between those two is that where the disconnection happened in the chain of narration, and also the number of people that got disconnected. Are you guys with me? Good. The second type is called what? Saqtun khafi. It's what? It's a disconnection which is not apparent. It's khafi, it's hidden. It's a hidden disconnection. Are you guys with me? And it's two types. It's called mudallas. It's the mudallas. And the mursal al-khafi. And the mursal, which is called mursal al-khafi. Mursal al-khafi. This type, which is called the saqta al-khafi, that type of saqt, وَهَذَا لَا يُدْرِكُ إِلَّا الْأَئِمَّةُ الْحُزَّاقِ الْفُحُول. No one is able to know that type too, that I just mentioned. The mudallas and the mursal al-khafi. Except the scholars of hadith, who are the حُذَّاق الْمُطَّلِعُونَ. The scholars of hadith who are tough, who are strong, who are able to follow what? طرق الحديث وعلل الأسانيد. The defects and the faults that occur in the hadith. Are you guys with me? Ibn Hajar now, he's going to start with which one? So that one is the first type of rejection. It's called, due to what? The first type is what? Saqtun Zahir. Why is it? Saqtun Zahir is because of the... So it's the first type of rejection, sorry, is called Saqtu Fissanad, the disconnection of hadith. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
And that's two types. Saqtun Zahir and Saqtun Khafi. Saqt Zahir is Mu'allaq, Mursal, Mu'dal, and Munqata'. Saqt Khafi is what? Al-Mudallas and Al-Mursal Al-Khafi. We finished that one. Now, we're going to go into the second type of why a hadith is rejected. Al-Ta'nu Fir-Rawi. The narrator is criticized. The criticism directed towards the narrator. And as I said, at-ta'nu fir-rawi, the criticism that happens to a narrator happens because of two. He gets criticized for two things. What are they? His adala, his reliability, and the second one is dabt, his memory. Both of them are five types. Each of them are five types. The criticism that is directed at his adala, his reliability, are five. Al-kadhibu, he lies. Al-tuhmatu bil-kadhibi, he's suspected to have lied. Al-fisqu, third, he's a fasiq. Four, bid'a, he fell into innovation. Five, al-jahala, he's unknown. And the jahala that I'm referring to here is called jahalatul ayn. We're going to take the jahala two times, jahalatul hal and jahalatul ayn. It's the jahalatul ayn. As for the criticism that is put towards his memory, it's also five times. Fuhshul ghalat, his memory is severely, he gets it wrong too much, you see. Second one is su'ul hifd, he has a bad memory. Three, al-ghafla, he's a heedless person. Four, kathratul awham, he has excessive wahm that he does. And five, which is mukhalafatul thiqat, he's known to oppose the other narrators a lot. All of those, we're going to take them in details, you don't need to know what they all are right now. So any hadith which you hear is weak. Anyone who ever tells you there's a weak hadith out there, you're going to ask them for what reason. Is it a saqtu fi sanad or is it a ta'nu fi rawi? If he says to you it's a saqtu fi sanad, the hadith is disconnected, you say, barakallah fiqh. What type of saqt are you talking about? Are you talking about saqtun zahirun or are you talking about saqtun khafi? He'll say to you, brother, I'm talking about saqt zahir. He says, barakallah fiqh, if you're talking about saqt zahir, I know four types. Mu'allaq, mursal, mu'dal, and munqat. Which four are you talking about? If he says to you, no, I mean saqt khafi, you say to him, what are you talking about? Al-mudallas? Or are you talking about mursal al-khafi? He said, no, I don't mean at all. It is not even a saqtu fi sanad. Hey, what is it? It's at-ta'nu fi rawi. The narrator is criticized. So you say to him, okay, what is the criticism towards? Is it his adala, his reliability? Or is it towards his hifd? Or his dabt, his memory? He says to you, brother, it is directed towards his dabt. He's adala. You see, if he's adala, is he a kadhib? Is he a kadhib you have against him? Or do you have a mutamun bil kadhib? Or is he suspected to have lied? Or is it al-fisq? He's a fasiq. Or is he fell into innovation? For remember, the innovation are two types: bid'atul mukaffara and bid'atul ghayra mukaffara. Bid'ah, which he becomes a disbeliever, kafir because of it. Like the bid'ah of the Jahmiyyah, who said that the Quran is created. And there's another type of bid'ah which is not bid'atul mukaffara. It's not bid'ah, this disbelief.